Hello, everyone. How are you getting on with your studies these days? Have you found the time to go over all the previous lessons we have studied? 今天我们又将听到一个有趣的故事。这个故事还带着典型的英国人的幽默。讲的是什么呢？我先给大家透一点口风，讲的是关于政治 ,politics。好，我们还是从学习生词开始吧。Election, former, defeat, fanatical, opponent, radical, progressive, suspicious. 这篇课文的题目是 After the elections, 大选之后。那么大选之后究竟发生了什么呢？当然是胜者为王，败者为寇。还有其他的吗？好 ,we shall find the answer in the text and while watching the cartoon. 下面是关于课文的四个问题，请大家谨记。What happened to the former Prime Minister in the recent elections and where is he now?在最近的大选中，前任首相怎么样了？他现在身在何处 ？Does Patrick support the former prime minister and his party? Patrick, 他是不是支持前任首相以及他的政党 ？Where did Patrick go after the elections and what for? 在大选结束之后。Patrick 去了什么地方？为什么目的而去 ？Why did Patrick ask the policeman on duty the same question again and again? Patrick 为什么老问那位当值的警官同样一个问题
？The former Prime Minister, Mr. Wentworth Lane, was defeated in the recent elections.He is now retiring from political life and has gone abroad. My friend Patrick has always been a fanatical opponent of Mr. Lane's radical progressive party. After the elections, Patrick went to the former Prime Minister's house. When he asked if Mr. Lane lived there,Policeman on duty told him that since his defeat, the ex-prime minister had gone abroad. On the following day, Patrick went to the house again. The same policeman was just walking slowly past the entrance when Patrick asked the same question. Though a little suspicious this time, the policeman gave him the same answer.The day after, Patrick went to the house once more and asked exactly the same question. This time, the policeman lost his temper. I told you yesterday and the day before yesterday, he shouted. Mr. Lane was defeated in the elections. He has retired from political life and gone to live abroad.I know, answered Patrick, but I love to hear you say it.
这确实一个让人忍俊不禁的故事。我在想，如果真有一个政治家遭人恨到如此程度，那真是他莫大的悲哀。好，看看我们的四个问题，大家都有答案了没有？第一个问题 ，What happened to the former prime minister in the recent elections, and where is he now?回答是 ,He was defeated in the recent elections and has now gone abroad. 原来他连任失败已经移居海外。第二个问题 ,Does Patrick support the former prime minister and his party? Oh no, he has always been a fanatical opponent to the former prime minister and his party. Patrick 一直是一个狂热的反对者。第三个问题 ,Where did Patrick go after the elections and what for? 回答是 He went to the former prime minister's house to ask the policeman on duty if Mr. Lei, the former prime minister, still lived there. 他呀就喜欢跑到前任首相的住址问当班的警官前任首相是否还住在那儿。最后一个问题 Why did Patrick ask the policeman on duty the same question again and again? Well, that was because he loved to hear the policeman say Mr. Lei was defeated and has now gone abroad. 故事寥寥数语但是 Mr. Lei 前任首相的失意和 Patrick 的得意已经活灵活现地呈现在我们面前，这正是作者的高明之处。下面我们一起来看看课文中的语言点。首先请看 He is now retiring from political life and has gone abroad. 我们都知道 retire 的意思是退休，那么大家关注一下它后面接的介词 from。In Britain, women usually retire at the age of 60 and men at the age of 65 when they can get a pension. 英国的女性通常是60岁退休，男性65岁退休。请多看几个例句。Gladys retired at the age of 68. Gladys 68岁退休。They had decided to retire from farming. 他们决定不再从事农业工作。Women and men will be able to retire 5 years earlier. 今后男人和女人都可以提前5年退休。再来看看课文中的这句话。The policeman on duty told him,that since his defeat, the ex-prime minister had gone abroad. 大家注意一下 on duty 这个表达法，它的意思是当班的、当职的。又比如 There were only 2 prison wardens on duty when the riot started. 暴乱发生的时候，只有两位狱警在当班。I am on duty now. I can't leave. 我正在值班呢，不能走。还请关注一下 ex-prime minister 这个名词词组中 ex 这一前缀的用法。这一前缀的意思通常是表示前什么什么。又比如 British, ex-British, servicemanex-serviceman, wife, ex-wife. 好，课文中还有这样一句话。Though a little suspicious this time, the policeman gave him the same answer. Suspicious 的意思是怀疑，它的后面通常接介词 of, 表示怀疑某人或者某事。请看例句。The policeman on duty became suspicious of the youth and asked him why he was standing there. 当班的警官怀疑起那位年轻人，询问他为什么站在那儿。I am suspicious of the government's intentions. 我很怀疑政府的真实意图。还请注意 suspicious是由名词 suspicion 变来的。那么名词 suspicion 的意思就是怀疑。比如 John had always shared Anne's suspicion of Michael. John 和 Anne 一样都很怀疑 Michael. Their friendship is regarded with suspicion by their teachers. 老师们对他们之间的友谊表示怀疑。这句话中有一个很有意思的表达 lost his temper 表示某人发火了。我们下面看一看 temper 做脾气讲的时候可以被哪些形容词来修饰。He had the most violent temper. 他的脾气非常暴躁。A quick temper 是急性子。He was a man of surprisingly mild temper for an artist. 作为艺术家来说，他的脾气的确是非常温和。我们可以说 mild temper。与 temper 相关的还有一个表达法是 lose one's temper 或者 fly into temper， 意思是暴怒、盛怒。比如 She suddenly lost her temper and left the room， 她突然非常生气走出了房间。好，课文中的原点我们就讲到这儿。现在我给大家布置一个任务，你们找出课文中出现的时态，数数一共出现了多少种时态。都找出来了吗？我统计了一下，大概是六种。你们呢？现在我们就一起来看看这六种时态的用法有什么不同。首先是一般现在时，比如这句话I love to hear you say it. 我就是喜欢听你这么说。一般现在时通常表示经常发生的动作或者永恒的真理或者目前存在的状态。第二种是一般过去时，比如课文中的这句话 The former prime minister was defeated in the recent elections.前任首相遭受失败。我们用一般过去时叙述过去连续发生的动作或者事情，或者表示过去一段时间内经常或者反复发生的动作，或者是持续了一段时间的状态。第三种时态是现在进行时，比如 He is now retiring from political life.我们用现在进行时表示讲话时或者包括目前在内的一段时间内正在进行的动作。第四种是过去进行时，比如 The same policeman was just walking slowly past the entrance when Patrick asked the same question. 我们用过去进行时表示过去的某一时刻或者过去的某段时间正在进行的动作。课文中出现的第五种时态是现在完成时，比如 My friend Patrick has always been a fanatical opponent of Mr. Lane's Radical Progressive Party. 用现在完成时表示一个已经发生但是对现在的情况有影响的动作，或者是从过去的某个时候到现在这段时间里发生的事情，或者是一个由过去的某个时候继续到现在的动作或者状态。最后，课文中还出现了过去完成时，比如 The policeman on duty told him that since his defeat,The ex-prime minister had gone abroad. 当班的警官告诉他，在大选失败之后，前任首相已经出国了。我们用过去完成时表示过去某一时刻之前已经发生的动作或者情况。好，关于课文中出现的六种时态，它们的基本用法，我们就简单介绍到这儿。我们的课文讲的是一个大选失败的前任首相，大家知道吗？英国的大选一般是每五年举行一次，主要是两个最大的政党，保守党和工党之间的角逐。Now, back to Mr. Lane, the former Prime Minister. Do you think he has been a successful Prime Minister? And what qualities do you think a person must have in order to be a successful politician? 大家把这些问题带到课后去想一想吧。 OK, that's all for this lesson. Thank you, and see you next time.